Todd Hoddick, current point leader. Mitch Brown, second in points coming into tonight. 20 points apart. Glenn Stires, hot off of two straight wins, now just 35 points out of the top spot. Keith Dempster sits fourth, 49 points out. And Corey Turner rounding up the top five coming in to tonight's feature event. Field takes formation. And in memory of Frankie Turkey, the field goes to the open pole. Thank you very much to the family of Frankie Turkey for joining us here tonight. And a special night that we know here for Glenn Stires when we were setting the schedule. This was one he wanted on the calendar as part of the 20th season at Ohsweken Speedway. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we want to get you on your feet. 15 strong, ready to go 20 laps. This is the Corpac Merchandising Sprint Cars in memory of Frankie Turkey. The Strickland GMC Pace truck will pull off the track and we get ready to go green flag racing. Jim Hoopin and Mitch Brown on the front row. Kyle McKenzie with the double greens in hand. Ladies and gentlemen, you came looking for a show. Well, here you go. Let's end all the anticipation as we bring to you our feature presentation.
Here we go, green flag in the air. Jim Hoopin in the front row. First feature win in quite some time here as it leads him down into corner one and two. The first time Brown around the outside, and now Dempster spins it in corner two. Costa and the rest of the field narrowly avoid.
Nice job by everyone to get by Keith Dempster, who loops the five around in corner number two and brings out the yellow flag. Brian again.
And Dempster very narrowly missed by the field, guys. He certainly had to Gulper through that one. No harm, no foul. It'll be a complete restart with Dempster to the back. No laps in.
Hoopin and Brown, row one. Stires and Turner. Jamie Turner, that is, row two. Corey Turner, Todd Hoddick, row three. Coming back to the green flag. 20 laps of distance in the A main.
Here we go again. Hoopin in with a good start. Stires with an even better one as they almost go full wide down the front stretch.
Stires looks to the inside of Hoopinen, but it's Hoopinen and Brown breaking away. One and two, Stires back to third with the Turners, duking it out with Dane Nida for fourth.
Brown started on the outside. He's got to run that group so well. You know he's the first to run the bottom, but again to the top side and run it two.
Dane Nida hit a big bump there in corner number one, shoots up the track right in front of both Turners, and now slides back into that fifth spot.
So Jamie Turner to the inside, meanwhile up front, Brown again to the outside of Hoopinen looking for the lead. But Hoopinen continues to lose the two laps on the grid.
Hoopinen looking to get back to victory lane. As you said, Tommy, it's been quite some time since we've seen the 14H in victory lane. Mitch Brown looking to get by him on the high side.
Well, Hoopinen ran a bit of a quicker lap there, but Stires now starting to reel in both of them as he's up on the top side. Hoopinen on on the bottom again and catches a bit of a rut down there entering turn three.
Off a corner four, Brown again. Can't get by the 14-H of Jim Hoopinen, who leads away. Great run through one and two that time for Brown, but Hoopinen so strong in the bottom line.
Very even top and bottom here with Stiers and now Nida starting to recover from that problem. Brown takes the lead out of corner four though.
Brown has the top spot. Got the win on Saturday night at South Buxton. Looking to make it two in a row. So he goes wheel to wheel with Jim Hoopinen.
Hoopinen fights back to the inside. Brown to the outside again. As Brown will lead that lap, but Hoopinen is there, and here comes Stiers.
Brown on the outside. He's got Stiers right in his tire tracks. Hoopinen hanging down the bottom side, and Dane Nida trying to catch the top three. And he's running a good lap time here.
And Nida quick in that 77. Now Brown gets clear of Hoopinen. Stiers now to the tail end of the 14-H. As the top side is the preferred way around at the moment, Hoopinen maintains the second spot for a moment though.
Brown, your leader. Here comes Stiers now working on second place. Jim Hoopinen on the outside line, and he will clear Hoopinen into the runner-up spot.
Hoopinen may have to try a different line here, but sometimes the setup doesn't work to your advantage. Stiers to the inside of Brown in corner two. Now he gets to the inside again as he tries to put the slider on Brown. No dice over the corner that time.
And Brown will clear, and now it's Hoopinen and Stiers going back at it as they've hit some lap traffic. John Dubrich Jr., the first car to go a lap down.
So Brown, Stiers, and Hoopinen now all on the top side. Nida drops down to the bottom looking for a way to catch up as Brown works on putting a lap on Lou Winger.
Halfway through this one with Mitch Brown leading over Stiers and Hoopinen. The top two have been the top two drivers here in Ontario in the last number of weeks. In fact, going back to last year.
And all of last year, they fought over the points lead in both SOS and Fairfax. Stiers with the big slider try there. Couldn't get that done, and now he falls back behind Brown as Nida really catching up to the top three now.
Similar situation to last Saturday night at South Buxton Raceway, where Stiers was all over the back end of the 10 car, but just couldn't get it done. He gets a great run that time off of corner two.
Stiers again to the inside with a slider. Can't get it done. Brown will lead out of corner four with now seven laps to go, as Hoddick gets up over the end of corner four and back on track.
The point leader trying to get himself a little bit higher. He's into the top five, but fading from the leaders.
Brown and Stiers have now broken away from Hoopinen just a bit here as Brown continues to work into this traffic. Stiers chasing the Brown machine, but not able to get by yet.
And they work down to the outside of Connor Mahoney, coming down to the big high five from Kyle McKenzie. Brown will lead with five laps to go. Stiers second, Hoopinen third, and Nida continuing to close.
Brown's been on the top side pretty much the whole race. If he's got to go to the bottom here, we're not quite sure what he's got. As Stiers shoots between Mahoney and Brown up into the lead briefly, Brown going to turn it back under in the side-by-side on a corner four.
He couldn't get it back though, and Stiers goes to the point. Here comes Brown down the inside line, and Stiers will go by and clear Mitch Brown and into the lead.
Hoopinen recovering and getting back to the inside of Brown for the second spot. Nida, after gaining some ground, is starting to fall back again, and Stiers pulling away up front with three to go.
Working it down the back stretch. Glenn Stiers now sees the lap car of Ryan Turner in his sights, running up in the line that he wants. It'll be two to go this time. The lap car directly in front.
Two to go for Stiers as he looks for feature win number 25 here at Ohsweken Speedway. Trying to put a lap on Turner now as Brown and Hoopinen fell back.
Coming down to the white flag, Stiers with a big slide, goes off the cushion there and nearly into the wall. One lap to go, trying to make it three in a row here at Ohsweken.
Well, you know, Stiers is on the hammer as he gets out of corner four there, but through three and four, the final time, Stiers is going to come around and get his 25th career feature winner at Ohsweken Speedway. Second will be Brown. Third at the line, Hoopinen holds off Nida. Then it will be the 49 of Todd Hoddick. Jamie Turner finishes sixth. Jesse Costa seventh. Derek Jonathan eighth. Corey Turner ninth. And Shane Ross rounds out the top 10.
Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, we still have two feature events to come this evening.
The Donut, in memory of Uncle Frankie. Three in a row for the Ohsweken Flyer, Glenn Stiers, as he heads down to Mobile One Victory Lane. Again, we want to thank the fine folks from Lowell Fireworks for providing the fireworks we see up in the sky every Friday night here, Highway 54 in Middleport. And again, we want to thank Case IH, O'Neill's Farm Equipment, tonight's race night sponsors, as they will push Glenn Stiers here to Mobile One Victory Lane. What I'm sure will be an emotional win here for Glenn Stiers. 46th career win, 25th career win at Ohsweken. He's got the helmet off. Getting ready to climb out. He's got all kinds of family down here in Victory Lane. We'll get him the Mobile One hat. Let's hear for the Ohsweken Flyer, Glenn Stiers. Glenn, if you're going to pick a night to win, this was it.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. Uncle Frankie has all the stuff to do with this orange and white, in case you guys ever wondered. And I lost him when I was 7 years old.
So an emotional night. You got all the family here. And boy, that wasn't an easy win either.
Yeah, I know. Mitch is pretty tough. He normally doesn't run the top like that. And I just got a run off of him, like out of the corner, and just got by him. I don't know how much room I left him, but hopefully it was enough. But it was fun. It was great. The track was amazing. Stan did a heck of a job tonight. And Steve Moulton, my car, another awesome job.
Third straight win at Ohsweken. 25th career win here. Pretty impressive streak you're on.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. I mean, like I said, you got to take these wins when you can get them. A lot of, like in the beginning of the year, I was breaking and not very successful. And tonight, you know, the last few nights, nothing's broke. So I've been getting all of everything going my way. It's been incredible.
Who would you like to thank for the win?
Well, first of all, my cousin Mal, he's my business partner with Lone Wolf and Lynn. We put this car together special tonight. He's been bedridden, and I'm hoping that he comes up here in the Victory Lane tonight. But our whole goal, like, he was not able to get out of bed for the last 2 weeks, and we wanted to do something special for him to get him out here with us. And because, you know, we just don't know how much longer he's going to be with us, and it's all for him tonight.
Well, we'll let you celebrate with your family. Let's hear it for the Ohsweken Flyer, Glenn Stiers, the winner here on Frankie Turkey Memorial Night. Clint Jeffrey.
I got Mitch Brown here. Mitch, we don't normally see you run the outside, kind of trying to take a page from Glenn's book tonight, but the track really played into your hands on the top side. You did everything you could. The leader's sitting duck sometimes. Is that the case tonight?
Yeah, basically, Glenn Stiers showed me how to run his line, and that was it. And I guess he was the only one better than us tonight.
We don't see a lot of the aggressive slide jobs that we saw tonight. Glenn threw one on Dylan a couple nights ago, and tonight, real aggressive dive into the bottom. What goes through your mind when you see that zero blasting out in front of you?
You get a little nervous, and it makes you drive harder, and you start making little mistakes, and then eventually it gets you.
Still near the top of the points, good and run for Mitch Brown here tonight, and Greg standing by with a former champ, Jim Hoopinen.
Yeah, standing here with the Red Rocket, and Jim, not a win, but on the podium, you have to feel good about the finish here tonight.
Yeah, you know, we haven't had the best of years. You know, we broke the part of the motor on the first night and then rolled over there with by getting help with that. But, yeah, you know, tonight the track was a little bit smoother. Still a couple of bumps, but it's better than it has been, and you know, I'm happy to be up here. You know, I got to thank all the sponsors. You know, I got people from Dunville Silo here tonight, and they've been a big supporter. And, you know, it's just been one of those years. And we're looking to go to Knoxville Nationals to run the 360 in August, so we won't be here. But, you know, it's we're going to have fun this year.
There you have it. Jim Hoopinen coming home third tonight on Frankie Turkey Memorial Night. Let's have a big round of applause for our top three here this evening. The whole family getting in on the shot here on Frankie Turkey Memorial Night. See Aaron Turkey there in the mix. And a perfect night for a victory for the Ohsweken Flyer. Glenn Stiers, three in a row, started all back on the Triple Crown Showdown night. Then he won again last Friday night in the SOS versus Corpac Showdown. And then again here tonight. And a second place last Saturday night down at the South Buxton Raceway. All these guys will head back down to the Brighton Speedway tomorrow night for the seventh round for the Southern Ontario Sprints. Make sure you log on to www.southernontariosprints.com for all the updates down there. And you can follow me on Twitter at Greg on the Mic and also on Facebook. And we'll have all the updates as Glenn Stiers, Mitch Brown go at it for the championship of the SOS as well.
Well, as we finish up in Mobile One Victory Lane, we're set for two more features here on O'Neill's Farm Equipment Case IH Frankie Turkey Memorial Night. The HRW Automotive Mini Stocks next up on the schedule. 28 mini stocks are set to go in their 15-lap feature. The winner of this feature will draw the winning 50-50 number, so make sure you get your 50-50 tickets out at the end of the mini stock feature. We're at $1,135 for the prize on the 50-50. And here's your lineup for the 15-lap HRW Automotive mini stock feature event. Starting in the pole in the number 11, it's Mike Pinball Guyverson. Starting second in the